So Maria Sharapova, paragraph number 3. I used to be so lonely, Maria Sharapova recalls. I missed my mother terribly. My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going. So he couldn't see me either. So mother was already not with her. And even father, who was with her physically, but actually he could not give her much time because he was always busy in earning money. Last pencher, beta, be careful. I don't give many chances, that boy, corner boy. Because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 8 p.m. The other tennis pupils would come in at 11 p.m. and wake me up and render me to tidy the room and clean it. So being young, because she was a child only. So she would sleep at 8 o'clock in the evening, and when the seniors would come at 11 o'clock, they would wake her up and would make her tidy the room and all. So this was no less than what would you call as bullying, bullism, okay, which many people call as harassment. Okay, when somebody sees that the other person is not very emotionally or physically strong, the other people try to emotionally harass him or her. So this is not blackmail. It is when you hurt somebody. So she was a victim of bullism at that age. So what happens? Bullism sometimes makes us weak. Stand up, you. That boy. Kya naam aapka? Okay, Lakshay will tell us that what used to happen with her in the room. Yes, sir, this boy. Okay, sit down. You talk. Sit down, you. Sit down. So the seniors would bully her. The seniors would harass her. How? By waking her at 11 o'clock and by making her do the cleaning of the room. If somebody asks you to clean the room, that is not a big deal. That's not really wrong. But the wrong is the way you make somebody do it. The way you disrespect somebody's right. Everybody has a right to sleep at 11 o'clock. Please don't disturb us like this. No. What's your name? Instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. So I was talking about like bullism makes us weak. But the great people are exactly the opposite. Bullism made her become stronger and determined. She decided that she would take the revenge of bullism, harassment, insult by becoming great. Weak people, you know what they do? They get determined to take revenge. They are weak people. Great people decide to take the revenge by becoming successful. Because they know that the best answer to respond to insult is becoming great. Because once you become great, you will be getting respect from the whole world. That would be the biggest response to insult. Okay? I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting because I knew what I wanted. So she never thought about quitting. She might have thought about quitting. She's saying that I never thought about quitting. She might have, but she might have become determined to succeed because she was a strong girl, right? I knew what I wanted. What makes you go on? What makes you go on and on? Yes, determination, your strength of character. Some people say that somebody is, you know, many people go to gym and all, try to become strong. You know, they try to show the muscles. But actual strength is your strength of mind and character. If your mind is weak, if you cannot control yourself, you are the weakest creature on this earth. When you don't have a control on your senses, when you cannot control your simple mouth from talking nonsense, no one is weaker than you, mind it. The strongest person is the person who has got the strength of character and mind. Okay, character is how people know you. Are you known as a disciplined, hardworking, honest, and diligent fellow? Or are you known as a talkative person, a nonsense person? Your reputation is what you tell others. Okay, and your character is formed by your habits, by the way you show yourself. Got it? So be a man of character first. Have strength of mind. Go to gyms later on. A weakest, short person can control the whole world. And sometimes even a tallest and the, you know, strongest person may become a victim to embarrassment or harassment. There are wrestlers whom you know, like, they are doing very well in the world, but they may not talk with you for 5 minutes. They are not strong. Strong people are the ones who can be convinced, who convince others, rather. They are the strongest people. That's why it is said that pen is mightier than the sword. What is mightier than sword? Pen. And pen is what? Pen is idea. Knowledge. Okay, knowledge is more powerful than anything else in the world. Does Karan. So when you come from nothing, and you have nothing, then have put up with much more, then it makes you very hungry and determined. When you come from nothing and you have nothing, what does it mean? When you come from nothing means when your background is very poor, when you come from nothing means when your family has not given you name or fame, when you have to make yourself from scratches, when you start your life from scratches, from zero level, that is when you come from nothing. Okay, when you are nothing means when right now you don't have anything with you. But yes, you can have everything for yourself for the future with your own strength of character, mind, soul, plus hard work. Biggest quality of a man, the biggest strength of man is his ability to control himself. When you cannot control yourself, like some weakest people in the class, there are some weakest people who cannot shut their mouth. They are the weakest people, I'm telling you. Okay, and in your life also, you will see you give them an empire. You give an empire to the weakest people. They will make that empire turn into a slum after 5 years. Because they will never have any sense to make better out of good. They will make the worst out of best. So weakest people are the one who don't have control upon themselves. Mind it. Keep these words in your, mind forever. Don't talk to others. Teach this thing to yourself. So this girl, she knew that when you come from nothing and you have nothing, then it makes you very hungry and determined. When you know that you have to do everything from your side, then you become hungry for success. But when you know that there is somebody at your back when you know that there are your parents who are pampering you to become businessman, beta, koi baat nahi, don't study. Okay, when there is somebody at your back, you know, then you are there too, then you become idler. Because you don't have hunger to do anything in your life. But I'm telling you, you give an empire to the stupid person, empire will become a slum. Remember it. So it is very important you become a strong-minded person first. So when I would have put up with much more humiliation and insults than to steadfastly pursue my dream. What is humiliation? Humiliation is insult. So the girl said that in order to become successful, I was ready to tolerate insults. She knew that she had to become what was in her mind. And for that, she was not ready to leave the place where the people were insulting her. Got it? Okay, that toughness runs through Maria even today. So that toughness, which toughness are we talking about, Jayant? Which toughness are we talking about? That toughness runs through Maria even today. Keep setting an answer. Keshav will not speak. That toughness, which toughness, dear? Mental toughness, which toughness, strength of character? The toughness which was of her character. She was ready to face all challenges to become successful. And that strength is still now with her. Obviously, if as a child, if you had been very strong, then when you'll grow up, will you become weak? No. So it's not worthwhile writing it. So this toughness runs through her even today. Which one? I would have, okay. See this, I just explained its meaning in one line. I would have put up means tolerate. I would have tolerated the humiliation and insults than to steadfastly pursue my dream. So she was like, what was her dream? To become a tennis player. So she would have suffered the humiliation instead of leaving it. But here, than to steadfastly pursue my dream, here actually comparison is not there. So the line is not very well framed, but the writer only wanted to convey that she was ready to pursue her dream at the cost of bearing humiliation. You know, sometimes we say, I can do everything, but I cannot bear the insult. But she said, I can do everything to pursue my dream. And sometimes we say I want to become this, but I cannot tolerate this. But she said, I want to do this and I will tolerate this also. Got it? So that toughness is still there in her. It was the key to her bagging the women's singles crown at Wimbledon in 2004. Look straight. I'm on paragraph number. Leave your that arm. Yes. That it was the key to her bagging the women's singles crown at Wimbledon in 2004 and to her meteoric rise to the world number one spot the following year. Okay, one simplest question from you people. One thing is very clear over here that in 2004, she became the number one women's, she got the title of women's singles. She got the women's number one player in tennis in 2004 after winning Wimbledon's title. Clear? Now my question is, when did she get the title of being number one in the whole world? 2005. In 2004, she won Wimbledon's singles. And in 2005, she got the number one tennis player's title. Okay, so 2004, she won Wimbledon's singles. And 2005, she became number one women's tennis player. Huh? It's written in the first paragraph also. What's the who is the weakest person in the class? Raise hand. Raise hand the one who is the weakest boy in the class. Yes. Is it a synonym? Is it an adjective? Is it a very good quality? Boys want to become strong. They want to be called as like very, very masculine. Would you like to be called as weak? Why you talk so much? Can't you control yourself? Just have a little restraint. And in order to have control, you have to do nothing. Just one thing you have to do. What is that? No, look at the book. When you will look at the book, obviously you will listen to me. Because whatever I'm speaking, it is going in your ears. Because I'm not speaking that dumbly. The things are going inside your ears. And from your side, you just have to look at the book and let your fingers or pens run through the lines I'm speaking. Nothing else you have to do. Is that clear? Don't say that you are weak. Look at the book now. I don't want any counter argument. So while her journey, paragraph number 7, while her journey, Jayant, while her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis has touched the hearts of tennis fans, for the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. She had her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia to the, Kriti, to the summit of women's tennis. What does it mean? What does it mean, Kriti? What's the summit? Summit is the highest point. So here the summit is of, keep sitting. Oh my God.